I'm at least at back reporting.
Right here, Greg.
Floyd says he may make the biggest bet he's ever made on himself for this fight. Are you going to bet on yourself in this fight?
I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe. No, man. That. I think he has he calmed down to brother. From seeing him, he gambles on half times and things like that. He shows what his wins are, never shows what the losses are. But that's why he's in this position he is in, and he had to take this fight. So, look,
take shit.
Focus on the fight. Not calm down.
Thank you.
A message for Conor McGregor here.
Very strong message from Floyd Mayweather in his speech. Says, it's not how you give it in boxing, but how you take it. How do you respond to that? That he's indicating that you're not going to be able to take his punches when you do it exchanges.
You know, I've come through a shin bomb. You ever had a shin bomb bounce off your cheek bomb? You ever come through that? You know what I mean? That's the game I come from. So. They can say what they want. I've come through a lot tougher than any of these have come through. So we are prepared. And like I said, I am prepared for the 12 3-minute rounds of insane pace, crazy fight. I'm ready for that. I just do not believe that he can give that. So
before the whole world up to this. Given what's been laid out about your career, your economic impact on boxing, the incredible career you've had. Given what you've heard all the way through the build-up to this fight from Conor, do you feel underlying he doesn't respect your skills?
At the end of the day, it doesn't really matter, you know, what a fighter or, you know, a guy that's competing against him say before he get in there. You know, it's different. To say it is different. You can say whatever you want to say when you're on the outside. Once you get inside that square circle, it's totally different.
Conor, you said you had a...
Come closer to the mic, please.
Hey, Conor, you said you had a great camp. If the fight goes how you hope it will go, could this be a career change and you've been talking to, say, one time deal? Could you perhaps switch careers and, you know...
The fight business is the fight business. Rule sets are that does not. You know, I can go into any rule set. That's what a true martial artist can do. I'm skilled in many forms of fighting. Truly, truly skilled in many, many forms. So, after I get victory on Saturday night, I will most certainly be looking to compete in both sports. I was joking, but I was actually thinking about it. Maybe going forward, since I'm the king of the boxing ring and the king of the octagon already, then maybe when I conquer both, maybe I might just create my own hybrid of an octagon and a boxing ring or something, and then, you know, have one bang in the middle of both of them. And if anyone wants to come and challenge me, it must be in my octagon, whatever way we come up with. But we'll see what happens. But. I'm an active fighter. I enjoy it. I don't stop thinking about fighting. So most certainly when this one is done, I'll have about 20 seconds where I'll be like, I'll relish in victory. But then I'll be like, who's next? So that's just the way I've always been. And I just turned 29 years of age. I'm still very young in my career. So. I will be able to compete all over the place.
One more question.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Eli Sekpak.